to yet another episode where Jaggu and I experiment on you. You are a little lab rats, aren't you? Yes, a lot of people have been telling
us,
enough experimentation, now you have got it. But we are not feeling confident, yeah. I think we'll know, maybe once we reach like a certain level of, you know, followers and subscribers, then we can start going live. Then thoda like huck se we can tell all our celebrity friends, ki aao humare saath interview karo. We will be approaching all of them.
Come play with us.
Yeah. And filhal, it is an experiment, but it's like we're happy enough with these episodes that we put them out there. And because you are our intimate group of 300, we like sort of like doing this just for us for now. Having said that, if you know anybody who's sort of like-minded, yeah, you know, your neighbors or your friends or office colleagues who did at one point listen to us on radio, unke saath hamara channel zarur share karna.
Please share. So as a matter of fact, if you're watching this, please to be liking, please to be commenting, please to be sharing, please to be subscribing, please to be doing all of that. The other way to resolve this whole live and recorded issue is to one day go live by mistake.
Hai na, Jaggu, one day we'll do it.
Yeah. One day just by mistake. Instead of record, we go live and that's that.
So we wanted to check with you what is going on in your part of the world, because in our part of the world, which is Dubai, little bit of a scandal happened, na, like a couple of days ago. Jaggu, we are not showing any images of this.
No.
Lekin,
no.
एक बहुत लाइक फैंसी एरिया में, विच इज द दुबई मरीना, एंड इवन इफ यू हैवंट बीन टू दुबई, यू हैव हर्ड ऑफ दुबई मरीना. आई डोंट नो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पार्टी हैपेंड, बट एट वन पॉइंट ऑल द पार्टी गोअर्स, मोस्टली लेडीज, वर लिटिल बिट स्टार्कर्स.
नो, इट वाजंट अ पार्टी, इट वाज एक्चुअली अ फोटो शूट. देयर वाज अ बकायदा कैमरामैन एंड ऑल ओवर देयर, इज माय अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट. इट वाज अ फोटो शूट, दे वर ऑल, हाउ टू से, नंगू पंगू
स्टार्कर्स, या
Starkers,
and okay, naked, the way we were born, like that.
Correct. Patte suit wala. And then they all come out on a long balcony, line up against the railing of the balcony, and somebody's happily shooting. The reason it went viral is that because this is happening khulega. So some neighbor of theirs who had a good angle, he took out his phone camera and shot the shooting. And that has gone viral.
Yeah.
Other pictures that have also gone viral is somebody inside the house who obviously took, you know, some general party shots.
I'm not quite sure. Like, yes, party thi where all the girls had to become naked, but anyway, we don't want to delve into it. But
party nahi thi, I'm telling you, photo shoot thi.
So, like, okay, so Dubai is quite liberal, but this is like pushing it.
Public mein is a bit of a problem.
And sometimes, like, I think sometimes the expats who live here a little bit are mental. Because
they
lose
track of the rules and regulations.
I'll have you know, ye jo videos hai, I only read about it in the news. Jaggu's wife was told by her mother ki dekho tumhare Dubai mein kya ho raha hai, and then Jaggu says, yeah, I have the photos and the videos. How did you have these photos and videos? We hadn't seen them anywhere, Jaggu.
Tarana, one day we will exchange phones.
No thanks.
Then you can get onto my chats.
It came on my school chat.
These things come on my school chat.
No, but your school friends are obviously not here in Dubai. They're all over the world.
And they get, photos, images, memes, jokes.
From
all over the world. Right. Literally.
Anyway,
like, I know what is going on in Australia and New Zealand also. Hamare do teen bande khade hain.
As far as scandal is concerned. Anyway, so this was like, this was the big sort of news in the last few days right here in Dubai. India to matlab 115,000, 115,000 cases of COVID, and people are still arguing about masks and all, though it just boggles our mind.
Yeah.
Like, please, we would like you to stop right now and remember to keep your mask on. Always have a spare mask in your bag. In fact, like doctors vagaira keh rahe hain, because it is spreading so fast, maybe double mask up or wear one of the nice thick mask which doesn't have like a gap and all on your face. Please,
there is something to be said for double masking.
Yeah.
Like, proven.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And like in the UAE, all of us, a lot of us have managed to get vaccinated. But India mein, what time lagega for a lot of you to reach your vaccination? So until then, all you can do is keep yourself safe, which is, faltu mein, please don't attend any election rally.
No.
Please vote if you are in a state where elections are on, but there is no reason to go to listen to any election rally.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I read a day or two ago that about 7 crore vaccines have been given to the Indian population. That is a lot of vaccines.
It is. Over a billion people.
It's 130 crore. So like little more than 5% of the population is vaccinated. We have some way to go. We do. So anyway, lage raho. In the meantime, please be safe.
Please be careful.
While on the subject of, COVID and lockdowns, and we're all dealing with that, right? Some of us are dealing with like second or third lockdowns and things like that. Shops and retail have taken the brunt of it.
Yeah.
They've, let's face it, they've taken the brunt of restaurants also. They've shut down, business nahi hai, stock pada hai, bech nahi sakte hai, online jo jata hai, so jata hai, wahan pe competition alag rehta hai. But like a regular dukandar, grocery store, storekeeper, hona, he's got a little bit stress in his life. Yeah.
Yeah.
Abhi halaki now they've, some of them in depending what region or which country or whatever, they're being allowed to open slowly, slowly, or the times that they are allowed to stay open is extended. You know, all of that is happening. So you have COVID, you have lockdown, you have people not visiting stores because it is a public area and it's inside, you know, it's not open air and all of that. After you deal with all of this, one fine gentleman in one lovely store, wait for it, then had to go and deal with this. Please, hame dikhaye.
That's like a Komodo dragon.
It is.
I didn't realize you could climb so nicely.
Doing a good job.
Because we don't speak the language, I cannot make out if these girls are excited or these are little shrieks of terror.
Oh, no.
It could be a combination.
I don't know what the dragon is supposed to be doing. Like, is it going towards, like, I don't know, the AC? Or is it because niche garmi lag rahi thi, or was there a hole in the roof and it wanted to go?
It's trying to get away from the squealing chicks. That's what it's trying to do.
Is that what is happening?
Is that a Komodo dragon or not?
I think it's a Komodo dragon. Oh, wait. It could be...
Is it a really, really big lizard?
No. I have seen these lizards. I have seen them in Sri Lanka. So it's a monitor lizard. It's not a Komodo dragon.
Monitor lizard. Got it. Anyway, you don't want one of those around.
Must be the same family. But I mean, that's a slightly surreal looking creature to be visiting a shop.
Abhi, he has gone and put up the display, opened his shop, laid out all the new stuff, all of that. And now that this lizard is going and dropping everything.
You think all the girls squealing are all the shopkeeper girls who are like, who's going to clean up after him? Who's talking him? Not me.
Who's going to get rid of him to begin with?
And also who's going to drive it out. Anyway, so that video surreal. Ended there. I don't know, but that is surreal. It has come in Jaggu's like wonderful like WhatsApp box.
Yes.
Okay. Moving on to more wonderful things. So in Mumbai, the BEST buses, which are basically the public bus transportation, they have had a rather peculiar problem. So for anybody who has traveled by the BEST, actually anyone who's traveled by bus, you realize that typically for your tickets, etc., this is back in the day, you would be using your change, like your chiller. And then you you know, like in Bombay at least, there are these, the conductor walks around with one full bag of like change. And that's where you typically break like a big note because you always have change and they're happy to like get rid of it, etc. So anyway, the BEST as a organization, as an undertaking, clearly gets a lot of cash, right?
Who buys ticket by credit card?
So now recently what has happened is they ran, their agreement with a private bank, which used to collect all this cash that they had from about 100 and 150 different depots, would take the cash and then basically put it in their bank and then they would have money in the bank. But that agreement with that private bank has run out. Tenders were passed in January. Now we're in April. In January, they had like said, okay, now these are our new bankers or whatever it is. But for some reason, there is a delay because of which the cash is not being picked up from these depots, because of which over 40,000 of the employees have been paid a rather large sum of their salaries in change.
Mana, literally, we're not even talking small currency notes. We're talking 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 50 paisa that way.
So,
how much are we talking here?
So there was a bus conductor saying, look, we've always been given a cash component and a check component. So like,
sure.
So say whatever, we used to get like 1,000 rupees as cash, which would be 2 rupee, 5 rupee, 10 rupee coins and notes maybe hundreds and 200s or whatever, and then the rest would get transferred into our bank accounts.
Sure.
Now that equation has gone up, and he said, like for example, last month I got 15,000 rupees in cash.
On our coins.
Yeah, in coins and currency. Whoa. And a lot of these employees don't live well close to their bus depot, and sure, they travel a fair distance, like 1 hour.
So they have to lug that and go.
So imagine carrying like a bag which is very heavy, and it is clinking and jingling. And you can hear that it's money. Nobody's going to think he's carrying chillar. They're probably going to think like sone ke sikke hai, or like there's some gold or whatever. So they said it's been very scary and it's very heavy. And we hope, like, you know, we get next month's salary properly. Oh, and poor things have been unable to like pay their EMIs, etc. on time. Because like, firstly, now you take all these coins and then deposit in your bank account. We're completely bizarre.
And every month you go to the bank and you put like one gunny sack of coins in front of the cashier has to count it. Yeah. You know, I'm feeling their pain, but the pain that we are not feeling is that of the BST ka HR and payroll department.
Okay.
They are the ones who are counting all the coins, creating piles for employee number one. Multiply that by employee number 5,000. Imagine what they're dealing with at this point. They must be starting.
There must be a coin.
There might be a coin
machine.
Counting analysis machine. Who
I
knows?
Haven't seen I haven't seen a coin machine, but there must be.
That does
prrr, and then it comes in one little.
Look, at some point I would get sick enough of it that I would have a weighing scale, and I'm like 500 grams of coin equals about 7,000 rupees.
At least they're getting paid, Jagu. At least they're getting paid.
They're getting paid.
Some of us have not seen our last payment. Anyway, quick reminder. If you like us and you've been having fun with us so far and loved that monitor lizard, like this video. Please remember, like the video. We need your likes. Remember to add a comment, whatever you feel like so far. And also to subscribe and turn that bell icon on and make sure you share it with like-minded people. Okay. I would like to now take you to South Korea, Jaggu.
I on South Korea.
Okay. I would like to share. Okay. So now this is a piece of art and it is about $440,000. Okay. So cool artist had apparently painted this painting in this particular art gallery. Okay. And it's apparently been destroyed.
Is this the destroyed version or is this the undestroyed version?
Yeah, so this is the destroyed. Correct. It's abstract and samajh mein nahi aa raha. Now, how did it get destroyed? Okay. So firstly, if I will try and zoom in on this. So all of these, I know it's pixelating a little bit, but all of these are basically paint bottles and brushes.
At the bottom. Okay.
But you can see that there is a yellow line.
Yes.
Right? So there's a yellow line. Behind the yellow line is where all this stuff is there. And above that is this very abstract painting. So about a few years ago, the artist had painted. It's called, the painting has been done by John Wan. He's an American graffiti artist.
Okay.
It is worth $440,000. It was done at this particular art gallery. So as part of their display, they left the paint that he used.
These were the tools of his trade that were used to paint.
And
this
to
very
show,
painting.
I guess to show off that, you know, this was made right here and it's our exclusive piece of work. A couple, on the other hand, by mistake in the last week of March, looked at all of this and said, they've said this is installation or, you know, but it could be interactive art or participatory art. And maybe everybody who's been like looking at this painting has been coming and adding their own flavor.
Okay.
So then they decided to paint over it. So now, Jago, try and guess which is the part that they have painted.
I really can't tell. That's the whole thing with this abstract. It could be anything. It could be nothing. Have they put that splotch of black at the bottom? Go back. Can you go back?
Yeah.
Oh, bang in the middle. I was actually thinking it was that black sort of curvy downward stretch.
Or maybe this.
What they've got.
Like this, right? This one.
That's what I thought it was.
Or like random this.
But it's the one above that.
It's this. Having said that, I think they've done a good job.
I think it's adding a little flavor.
Right?
Yeah. I'm thinking this $440,000 should be upped to a round figure of $500,000.
Yeah, like I don't think the value of this painting has been destroyed. Not because they should have just kept quiet about it, na? Because nobody would know.
Correct. But no, they want people to know. So now the artwork is famous. So now when it goes into auction, somebody will pay for it. Wo jaise Banksy ka hua tha na?
Correct.
The whole shredding and all of that. Whoa.
So they were arrested. This couple was arrested. And then they were let go. And the artist has said, you know, I don't care. It's fine. And the owner also has said, you know, they did make a mistake. And I think he's looked at it and said, actually, it's sort of blending nicely with the art. I mean, if somebody had made one giant smiley emoji,
that would have been a problem.
But I mean, if you must destroy art, at least be artistic about it is the moral of the story over here.
Correct. I think it's a wonderful look.
Yes, it is. While we're still in Korea,
I'm still analyzing why it's worth that much, but okay.
I have a bizarre story, not in Korea. I will come back to Korea, but so there's a wedding happening. Mother-in-law is meeting the daughter-in-law for the first time. Son has decided I'm getting married. The mother-in-law looks elsewhere. At the wedding, she looks at her daughter-in-law. This is a real story, okay? Looks at her daughter-in-law, sees that there is a birthmark on her hand.
Okay.
And says, oh my God, is it that birthmark? Goes up to the in-laws, so the girl's parents, and says, by any chance, your daughter adopted?
Okay.
The girl's parents are like, it's actually a secret, but how did you know?
Yeah.
So the mother-in-law has said, my birth daughter had the exact same mark.
Ooh.
And she went missing many, many years ago. And I looked all over for her. The police looked all over for her. We couldn't find her. And I think this is my daughter.
So the brother found his sister to marry?
Is what you would think. But there is a kahani mein twist.
Okay. Keep going.
The brother was adopted also.
There you go. Well done.
Yeah. So the bride to be was very excited to see her mother. She's like, it's the happiest day of my life. It's also my wedding. I can't marry my elder brother. And then the mother said, you can, because you're not really biologically related. When I lost you, I was so depressed that I went and adopted like an older boy.
And was that the time that the boy found out that he was adopted? Or did he
know? I don't know. But I guess at that point, he must have just been relieved to be like, as long as I can marry somebody and just not my sister.
Correct.
And everybody is happy.
What a crazy conversation this is going to be a couple of months from now. How do you all know each other? Well, let me explain this to you. Here is a flow chart. These are the ways that we are related. How is this going to happen?
But what a story.
What a story, man. What a story.
The headline was mother reunited with long lost daughter at son's wedding. And she was the bride. So immediately I've clicked on it saying, oh God, then what and all.
Wow.
And then there was a happy ending. So I'm very pleased with it. Very pleased.
Excellent.
Okay,
excellent.
Now I would like to go back to, where is it?
We were going back to Korea. Eye on South Korea.
Yeah, because the eye on South Korea is there for a very, very valid reason. Okay, now wait. So in South Korea, there are two islands, okay? Banwol and Bakji.
If you say so.
Banwol and Bakji, they were picked, selected for a tourism project by the government, which basically invested about $4.25-$4.25 million to make it a tourist attraction.
Okay.
And what did they decide to do? They decided to turn the entire two islands purple.
That is the tourism project. I'm purple banai.
We will make everything purple. So
Okay. Roads,
bridges, everything, houses, roofs, everything is in different different shades of purple. So there's lilac, there's lavender, and restaurants serve you purple rice.
Could happen. Could happen.
The residents who are mostly like senior citizens because their kids have gone off to like, you know, the big cities and all, and they are very excited that, you know, tourists are coming to visit us and all, get quite with the program and wear, and they also wear purple clothes.
Why not?
Apparently some grannies have said, I'm to wearing purple chaddis also, which everybody's very amused by. Nobody's insisting.
We'll just take their word for it. We'll take their word.
Yeah. And if you're a visitor and you wear purple and come to these islands, then you don't have to pay the entry fee.
Cool. And then maybe we get discounts inside.
Correct. And now we're going to leave you with some fantastic images because these are actually very cool. Are you ready?
I'm fully ready.
See?
Whoa. That looks pretty cool. It does look cool. Oh, nice.
So these are the roofs,
So these are the roofs, but I'm seeing a bunch of greenery. They're not growing purple cabbage. So
no, they are actually, but you can't see it. Okay. But I'll show you some more. Close up of more roofs. Okay. There, the grannies are all wearing purples. Yeah.
All wearing purple.
Grandpa. Grandpa is in one shade. Grandma is another. Shoes also, Jagu, if you notice, they're wearing like lilac shoes.
Oh.
Can you see?
Oh. Nice.
Very nice.
Okay, so we're seeing the costume. We're seeing the look at that. That's a bunch of shades of purple.
Yeah, no, and they're also growing lavender and lilac and all that, huh?
Oh.
Yeah. But quite cool. Nice.
Very cool. Very cool. Very cool. So listen.
This is the granny. This is my favorite photo of all the grannies.
Nice. And are those masks? They're purple masks also.
Obviously.
Well done.
If you're wearing purple chaddis, we have to wear the purple mask. So that is
mask also should be purple. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Hats, masks, everything.
Correct.
And see the road. Close up of a road.
Wow.
That's quite funky. There's a bridge as well as a road. And I'm going to...
A bridge as well as a... Ooh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is cute.
Yeah.
This is... Oh, lovely.
This is like full last photo. So this is the last shot.
Very good. Very good. This is cute.
Yeah.
But I want to take you to Senti.
You want to go to Senti?
Now, you know me and my relationships with barbers.
Your relationship with barbers?
Yeah. Once I find one.
Yes, you'll meet under the tree on occasion.
Yeah. Okay.
In Bombay, you should sit under the tree and get your hair cut, yeah?
Not really, but I can
close a couple. You told me I did it under a tree and all.
I came close a couple of times. I did a shaping under a tree. You're right. Huh. Because, you know, the hair grows over here, but the rest of my hair is not ready for a haircut. So, you know, this little bit touch up has to have side locks. Anyway, that's a whole separate story.
Hmm.
A gentleman has beaten my entire emotional relationship with barber shops.
Okay. How has he beaten it?
He has broken down in tears.
He loved his haircut.
This is not the barber's fault.
Okay.
Nor is it a compliment to the barber. When you walk into a barber shop somewhere in India, invariably there will be radio playing in the background. There will be one Bollywood song playing in the background.
No, there's always music.
Huh? Sometimes the TV is on, but usually radio, they've got one CD playing, MP3 playing. Nowadays, everything is very funky.
No, there's always music playing, yeah.
So this one guy walks in, getting his hair cut. Music is playing. One particular song, we're talking from the early 2000s. Hum Tumhare Hai Sanam. Shah Rukh, Salman, Madhuri.
Okay.
Song from there starts. This guy breaks down in tears. Clearly something that sab kuch bhula diya wala gana. Something has obviously touched his heart. But I think the touching might have gone a little too far. Please let me show you the video. It's going viral right now. He's crying. Everybody else is laughing. You see what I'm saying? You see, Amana.
Kameeni for wanting to laugh? Because that is damn funny.
There are many, many comments.
Also, the barbers were all giggling away.
Yes, there were many, many comments. Some of them were funny. Some of them, a lot of them felt his pain. Like, imagine the emotion must be going through. Imagine the breakup he must be thinking about. And one particular guy said, "Dil ki kamzori nahi hai. Dil unka saaf hai, saaf." Which is why he can shed tears the way he can. And you should not laugh at someone else's sorrow, which is very true. Tarana, you should not be laughing at someone.
I think the world is divided between, the senti types.
Yes.
That would be the jaggu and the crying at the barber shop.
I
and the non and the practical types. That would be me. What are you, dear viewer? Are you a senti kumar, senti kumari, or are you the song is playing? It's not really affecting me. I don't think I've ever been affected by a song.
No, but here's the thing: is there a song that you hear? You could
that
even
makes you senti.
You could hear it. Yeah.
No, senti as in like this, like aansu and all happens. Okay.
So is there a song? Okay, why not?
No,
something
like
that makes you emotional.
Yeah, no, because if a song, does a song remind you of anything? Obviously, there are like thousands of songs and thousands of memories associated with songs.
Yeah,
no.
Yeah.
Like this poor fellow who is howling, thinking of whoever gave him daga, listening to that particular song. We want to know from you, is there any particular song that makes you also tear up?
Yes.
Do let us know. I'm already telling you, I can't think of any other, I can't think of any song.
I can think of a bunch of songs that bring a smile to my face.
Jago, don't lie. I'm sure there's a song that you howl in the night with.
No, there's no song that
I howl in the night. Okay, Jago, add in the comments. He's refusing to tell me right now because I'll make fun of him.
Let me apply my mind to it.
Yeah. But I used to get senti after a particular breakup with a song called Big Girls Don't Cry.
Big Girls Don't Cry and you should start crying.
I'd get... bus. Not like... which is what he was doing. Not like that.
He was.
Yeah.
Napkins were not involved in your crying.
No. But I mean, look, you may be senti types and it's perfectly okay. We'd just like to know. So as we leave you, remember to first in the comments tell us, is there a particular song that makes you cry or at one point made you cry? We would really love to know. And of course, we'd love to know what you thought of this episode. It's not a special or anything. It was just like things that caught our eye.
It is that. Please like, please subscribe, please share, please comment, please tell your friends about us. Thank you very much. We should go.
Remember to mask up, double mask up. Stay safe, okay? We need you. Okay, bye.
Bye-bye, butterfly.